Oh, morning, Leo.
Morning, George. Hey, did you know that movie Jaws was filmed right here on Martha's Vineyard?
Yeah, I was here that summer, as a matter of fact.
Were you one of the extras in it?
No, I wasn't.
Are you sure? Because they reran it last night on TV. I swear, I saw you.
Somebody else.
That's funny. The second time that shark shows up, there's a guy swimming around in the background. He had a shirt on. Who else but George Duty?
There are a lot of people are sun sensitive, you know.
Well, that guy, whoever he was a real damn good actor, you know? He was screaming his head off. He even knocked over this old lady just trying to get to the shore. Well,
apparently, a number of people were frightened by how real the mechanical shark looked. So I heard.
Hi, George. Hi, Leo.
Ah, my darling daughter.
Hey, George, do you have a minute?
Sure.
Oh, great. You know, George, we're trying to set aside money for the baby, you know, for college. And, well, we're not really sure how to invest it. And you're so good at these things. Would you mind giving us a hand?
Well, I try to stay current on that stuff. I can research it and make some notes, and I'll give it to you tomorrow.
Oh, great. Thank you so much.
Oh, yes, honey. George and I will look into that and come up with a very good plan for you.
Oh, well, actually, you know, we were thinking this is more of a, you know, a George thing.
Do you hear that? My own daughter. She won't come to me for advice.
Well, you know, Leo, it is an area that I'm a little more familiar with.
Oh, so those are your big skills, huh? Money and fleeing from mechanical sharks.
For the last time, Leo, it was not me.
Hey, Dad, you'll never guess what was on last night. Your moment of glory. You sure did plow over that old bag.
Ambrose, I have a very important announcement to make. This is a very big day for me. I started a new chapter in my life.
Well, we'll miss you, but we think the world of you, and we wish you Godspeed.
No, I'm not leaving. I'm going back to school. I enrolled in some courses at the community college. Today is my first day.
Well, that is big news. Congratulations, Leo.
Oh, thank you.
Congratulations, Leo.
Thank you. You see, George, I just want to be the kind of guy that when my daughter needs answers to important questions, she will come to me. See, I want to be like you, except with a personality. Anyway, take a look at this, George, huh? This is my course load.
Now, this is good. Intro to business.
Yeah. See, I'm going to be learning all the stuff that you know. See, I just want my daughter to know that I'm a serious person.
Nude figure drawing.
Well, that's Pamper Leo time. Hey, how you cats doing, huh? Leo Wagon. How are you?
Wow, Leo, where did you get those clothes?
This is Ernie Caruso's, 12251 Tropicana Boulevard, Las Vegas, Nevada.
And what color exactly is that jacket?
This is Chateau Mauve Fire Mist. Had a car painted the same color. We looked spectacular.
Morning. Hello there. Hello, everyone, and welcome to... Introduction to business.
Dear, excuse me, if you'd be so good as to talk directly into the tape recorder, please.
I'll tell you what, sir. Today's session is going to be more informal. You probably don't need a tape recording of it. All right. I will now pass out the syllabus.
You will now pass out the syllabus?
Attached, you will find a reading list and course requirements.
Reading list and course requirement attached to said syllabus.
Sir, that is going to drive me nuts.
Will now be whispering from this point on.
I guess we should probably do some introductions. I am Judy McBride, your professor.
She is Judy
I swear
McBride.
To God, if you don't turn that thing off, it's going out of range.
There'll be a gap.
Let's start with you, sir. Why don't you stand up and introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Leo Wagaman. I'm a non-traditional student. In fact, I'm a non-traditional everything. All right, to be serious. I just got here to the Vineyard and... spent a lot of years in the entertainment capital of the world. I think you know I'm talking about Las Vegas, Nevada. Anyway, I certainly hope I'll be able to contribute that unique perspective to all the crap we have to learn here.
All right, okay, thank you very, very much.
You're welcome.
Mr. Wagman. And thank you for choosing Judy McBride's 9 o'clock class. Okay, who would like to go next?
Hello, everyone.
My name is Richard Kennedy. I'm here to learn all that I can from Professor McBride. I have big plans for myself. I'm going to become a successful businessman. However, it is a little tough for me. I lost both my parents last year in a fishing accident. Now I have to work at the ice cream shop, double shifts, to put myself through school.
Johnny Kiss-Ass, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, fine. Who's next, then?
Excuse me for the interruption.
Hey, George. Oh, thanks for bringing my textbook. Oh, Professor McBride, George Studi.
George Studi, that rings a bell. You look familiar.
He was in the movie, Jaws.
No, I wasn't.
Wait a minute. George Studi, who ran the mutual fund? Not the George Studi, who discovered the Studi effect?
Yes. I didn't know that you were familiar with the Studi effect.
Well, familiar with it. Look at the syllabus. I teach it.
Oh, you do? Well, I guess you have to.
Class, the Studi effect is a term used in equities research. It refers to the effect positive publicity has on share value. And the truth is, the more favorable publicity an equity issue has,
the lower the real value.
Yes. Counterintuitive, but brilliant.
I'm now bored out of my gourd.
And the student said, unemployment going down, right? That should be a positive sign. And I said, hey, not if you're making a positive interest rate play.
funny, because it's true, and true, because it's funny.
Yeah. Oh, George, I certainly have enjoyed getting to know you over the past couple of weeks.
Well, same here. You know, I really can't believe that someone as charming and attractive as you isn't, well, in the private sector.
I'm not that efficient.
Oh, you're killing me.
I really enjoyed lunch, George, but unfortunately, I have to rush off to my afternoon class. So, I guess I'll see you next time.
Yeah. Right.
Whoa, Mama. Dad, how was lunch?
Good. It was a nice lunch.
Yeah? Well, you've been having quite a few of these lunches with Judy. Are you guys going out?
Well, it's hard to tell. You know, I mean, in the old days, it was a lot clearer. You know, you dated a girl a couple times, her dad cleaned his gun in front of you, and boom, you were going steady.
Well, how many times have you two had dinner?
We haven't had dinner, just lunch.
Ah, well, you're in the lunch trap.
What does that mean?
Well, Dad, you see, lunch doesn't lead anywhere. It's a completely non-romantic meal. It's like, dinner that's been neutered. Plus, if you go out with a woman a certain amount of times, you're just friends, and that's all you'll ever be. You probably just forgot all this stuff. It's been so long since you were in the dating world.
Yeah, it's tough to remember, you know. We were so busy settling the West.
You know, if you ask me, I say it's time to kick it up to that dinner level, you know? Fix a nice romantic meal for her over at your place. Set the table, light the candles, and then ask her the important question. Is she seeing someone else? You know, and if she isn't, then you move on to step two. You tell her how interested you are in her and ask her if she's interested in you.
Yeah, but what if I do all that and then she says she's not interested in me?
Yeah, then as a face-saving maneuver, you must do two things. You pretend that you already have a girlfriend, and then you spread the rumor that Judy is a lesbian.
Well, I'm glad that hasn't changed. What are you doing, Jim?
I'm studying, George, studying. We have our first big business exam tomorrow. I'm just highlighting the crucial passages.
No, you're not. You're highlighting everything.
Well, how the hell am I supposed to know what's crucial? I haven't even opened this fucked-up book until just now.
Leo, you have to organize your material. Where's your study schedule?
Study schedule? What's that?
When I was in school, before a big test, I'd make up a study schedule. I'd break all the material down into sections, and then I'd spend an hour studying each section, and then just before the test, I'd go back over the material in a kind of a recap session.
Yeah, translation. George Studi had no friends.
I had a friend. I had friends.
Look, I don't have to study the Studi way. I do things differently. See, I'm all about pure adrenaline. I got a study group coming over tonight, some of my friends from school, and we're going to pull an all-nighter. I'm just going to cram everything I have to know.
Leo, you're never going to be able to stay up all night. I mean, you fall asleep before Final Jeopardy.
Hey, now, look. Just let me study the way I want to study. I don't need any lectures from you. And for your information, I am fully capable of pulling an all-nighter.
Should we wake him up? That is, if we can.
He must still be alive.
How do you know?
He's still holding his piece of pizza.
Does anybody know mouth to mouth?
I do. I mean, no.
Mr. Wagonman, you are quite late.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I overslept a little.
Mr. Wagonman, can I help you find something? Your eyes are everywhere.
God, I just have to do a little stretching after I wake up. Sorry.
Take your seat, Mr. Wagonman.
Come on, give me the answers to number one.
Leo, no. You're the one who slept all night. Now you have to meet the consequences.
Look, I went to war to protect your freedoms, you little bastard.
Instead?
Well, I wouldn't have. I had a showbiz exemption, all right?
Hi, George. Sorry I'm late. Busy morning.
Oh, well, that's right. It was the exam day.
Yeah.
How did Leo do?
Well, he was 30 minutes late, and then he sat there with that deer in the headlights look, so I'm guessing he probably flunked.
Yeah, I knew it. He didn't even prepare a study guide.
He didn't? Well, that's the only way to study. You've got to organize your materials. What?
Hi, Judy.
Hey.
Hi, Dad. Guys having lunch again, huh? Yeah. Kind of like little lunch buddies, huh? Listen, I've got some bad news. We have just run out of everything. Huh? We're out of lunch.
What do you mean?
So I guess you guys are gonna have to do dinner, and I've got a little idea. Why don't the two of you go over to Dad's house tonight for dinner? And since I ran out of lunch, I will make the dinner.
Well, that sounds great.
Great. Then it's a date. A dinner date. You're welcome. Oh, my. Leo, you scared the hell out of me. What are you doing in the car?
Look, I just need a little favor, okay? Now, I know you're cooking for George's day tonight, and she's going to be grading our exam, see? So, here's what I need. Just leave the front door open. Divert your father's attention. I could dash in and hide in the closet, see? And then at some point when the professor and your father are getting romantic, and here I make a giant assumption, I could slip my exam out of her bag, along with the smart kid's exam. Copy down all of his answers, slip both exams back in her bag. Bingo. I passed the test. What do you say?
Why do I suddenly feel like Vivian Vance? Leo, no, I'm not going to help you do this.
Oh, please, Ted.
No, it's
please.
Cheating. It's wrong.
Please, Ted. All right. I know I should have studied. I made a big mistake, but I learned from it. And because I learned my lesson, I think I deserve to cheat one last time.
You know you wouldn't be able to live with yourself even if you pulled it off?
Of course I would. You don't know me. This is nothing.
Leo, this is a big night for Dad, okay? A very important date.
What's so important?
Well, tonight he's going to tell Judy how much he cares about her. Look, he's a shy guy. He has a very hard time expressing his emotions. I don't want anything to screw this up.
I'm not going to screw it up. I'll just be hiding in the closet, copying down the answers. They'll never even know I'm there.
Where were you raised? In a cartoon? Leo.
Oh, come on, Ted.
You stay here. I'm going to go in there, deliver this food, and I'm going to shut the door behind you.
No, just don't.
Stay.
All right. Nah, he's right. You're making mistakes in life, you take your lumps. You pay the penalty, that's the way it's got to be. But the chips fall where they may. Oh, look, the schmuck forgot to shut the door.
That was a wonderful dinner, George.
Oh, well, thank you.
I'm glad Ted ran out of lunch. Dinner is more special.
Yeah, that's the thing about dinner. It's like lunch at night.
Yeah, and the salmon and puff pastry was spectacular. Your stock is certainly going up.
Well, your stock is high too. is your stock privately held?
No, at the moment I'm publicly traded.
I,
Are we talking about the same thing?
I hope so.
I was asking if you were seeing anyone.
Oh, yes, I know. And I was telling you, no, I'm not.
Oh, good, good, yeah. Yeah. Okay. So I kind of lost the thread there. Well, I think I'll clean up the
plates. No, here, let me help you.
Good thing there wasn't a gun in there. I would have shot myself.
Oh, I really love your house, George. It's so beautiful.
Oh, thank you. You want your wine?
Yes, please. And you have the most lovely view.
Oh, thank you. I really was glad to hear that you're not seeing anyone.
Well, thank you. I was glad you cared.
Yeah, and I've been wanting to, you know, to say something to you for a little while now. I've really enjoyed our lunches and now our dinner.
Come on, just say it, George. You can do it. Come on.
So I guess this is kind of a roundabout way of trying to say that I feel that...
It's not hard, George. Just go for it.
You know, you and I are...
Oh, my God, it's just three little words. Say it!
Heading towards a moment where I could say that I...
Oh, for God's sake, just say it, George! I like you, Judy. Is that so hard? Now, if you'll excuse me.
Excuse me. Leo?
Yes, George.
You want to come out here?
No, I'm fine in here, thanks.
What is going on here? Mr. Wagonman, get out here. Oh, hey, wait a minute. These are my exams.
Look, Judy, I can explain.
Okay, no, I get it. Mr. Wagonman was going to change his answers, and you, George, were his accomplice. You provided the romantic diversion.
Judy, I didn't even know that he was here.
I've never felt so used in my entire life. Well, I should have known. The big, glamorous mutual fund manager suddenly interested in me. A shy business professor. What an idiot I was.
Judy, that's not what happened.
Oh, yeah, sure. Well, I guess that just makes me the second victim of the Studi effect.
The second?
Yes, the first one being your mid-cap balanced fund back in 82, the year it saw a 25% loss.
I already have a girlfriend.
Whoa. Things are getting a little out of control here. Now, look, Judy. I'm the bad guy here, all right? I didn't study and I blew the test. I was trying to cheat because I just want to stay in your class. You see, I just want to be educated, all right? I just want to offer my daughter and my granddaughter some real wisdom. Look, flunk me if you have to, all right? Kick me out of the class, but please, don't blame George.
Well, I'm sorry, George. I panicked. I guess I just felt that on some level, all along, this whole situation was too good to be true.
Well, you need to get out a lot more.
All right, you listen to me. I am going to show mercy and not expel you, Mr. Wagonman. But hear this. I am tired of this aging hipster routine. I am tired of being called dear, I am tired of being called babe, and I am tired of the phrase Las Vegas. Nevada. I know it's in Nevada. Everybody knows it's in Nevada. And finally, I am really tired of your lackadaisical attitude towards your education. Now, from now on, you are going to study. You are going to work hard, and you are going to make something of yourself. Am I clear?
Look, dear, the only reason I specified Nevada...
Out.
Good night.
George, I'm sorry. Where were we?
I was just going to say, look, I may as well, you know, cut to the chase. I like you a lot, Judy, and I'd like to see more of you.
Well, I like you too, George, and I feel the same way.
Great. So, lunch tomorrow?
It sounds great. Well, I'd better be on my way.
All right.
Good night, George.
Good night. Well, you still got it, Studi. Matter of fact, you never lost it. So, to sum up, the Studi effect is all the more relevant in a bull market like this one, when new issues are surrounded by large amounts of hype. And I hope that in your investment future, you remember that, and I'd like to thank you. Thank you very much. I really enjoyed being your guest lecturer, and I'd like to thank Professor McBride for inviting me. So now, does anyone have any questions? Yes, the gentleman in the back.
Were you in Jaws?
No. Yes, young lady.
Are you sure? My dad said you were. He said you thought the shark was real.
Well, apparently a lot of people did. Well, I'm afraid our time is...
Mr. Studi, how much did they pay you?
50 stinking bucks.